would Bulbul and Leila say to each other if they were to meet?
If they were to meet?
Yeah, what would a conversation between the two be together?
See, Bulbul is a person who's very, you know, shy, and Leila is totally opposite of Bulbul. So I think unki jo conversation hogi, usme Bulbul, Leila usko wohi sikha rahi hogi ki kaise flirt karte hain ladkon ke saath.
Tripti and Avinash, the stars of the show, has it sunk in all those rave reviews coming your way?
It has, I think. I'm really glad that people are liking the film. Yeah, I think all my Instagram handle, my Twitter, my WhatsApp, I'm just like flooded with messages right now, and I'm so happy that people have finally loved the film that we've made, and you know, they're appreciating our work and our director's work and everybody who's there in the film. So it's just a great feeling, and yeah, there's so much fun.
Avinash, what about you?
I'm so glad. I'm really, really happy that it has got the kind of response that it has. Also the fact that everyone has really got what the film stood for and what Anmita wanted to say through the film. That has really reached out to the audiences, and in such an engaging manner. And it's just joyous to know that you're part of a film which has created a space and impacted so many people.
And also, I mean, when you guys were shooting for this movie, did you anticipate that this would get the kind of reception and, you know, it has?
Not at all. Like, mujhe laga tha, acha to bolenge, but itna wo nahi pata tha kabhi. But yeah, it's definitely a great feeling.
What about you, Avinash? I mean, like, when you were shooting, playing Satya, did you think that this movie will actually get the kind of reception?
No, so I remember saying it to all my friends, and I think I remember saying it to Tripti as well, that I had a feeling that it is special, that it's a unique film, is what I definitely had a sense of. Of course, how people will receive it, will they really get it, is something that you only know when it comes out. But I definitely had a feeling that it has something unique about it. There was, I had a special feeling, yes, I won't deny that. But yes, the reception is overwhelming. I am really pleased, especially I and Tripti together, considering we had done a film and, you know, it had its own kind of response.
Yeah.
And then this one came together. So it just feels nice that finally it has reached out to people and they can see that we're here and, you know, just acknowledge our existence.
And imagine both of you played star-crossed lovers in your debut, Leila Majnu. You're also off sorts. Off sorts, still, you know. What is it, yaar? I mean, aisi film mein tum dono ko kyun mil rahe ho? The star cross, never to be together.
Hamari kahani likhi hui hai. Jaisa Leila Majnu mein bolte hai na, I think wohi ho raha hai. Hamari kahani likhi hui hai. So,
the beautiful part about this, about Bulbul was that we, after Leila Majnu, we actually tested, both of us tested separately for the film. And, we had no idea. I had no idea that Tripti has tested for the film, and she had no idea that I had done it. Our director did not know about Leila Majnu.
She had not seen the film also.
Which is again, she had not seen the film. We were selected for it, and I'm like, "Acha, kaun kar rahi hai Bulbul?" And she says, "Tripti." I said, "Tripti kaun?" She like, "Dimri." I said, "Are Leila Majnu?" And she's like, "What Leila Majnu?" So yeah, it's been that kind of journey for us. Yeah. High five, yo. Dede.
Me too. And I'm also happy because I've interviewed you both for your first film. And when I saw you both, I was like, awesome. I mean, these guys have like done us all proud. Now, on a lighter note, Tripti, what would Bulbul and Leila say to each other if they were to meet?
If they were to meet?
Yeah, what would a conversation between the two be together? I'm coming to you also.
I know what they should speak. Anyways, let her first.
I think... See, Bulbul is a person who's very, you know, shy, and Leila is totally opposite of Bulbul. So I think unki jo conversation hogi, usme Bulbul, Leila usko wohi sikha rahi hogi ki kaise flirt karte hain ladkon ke saath. Especially Satya ke saath.
Satya ko kaise? Then what would they do? And she meets because Bulbul.
Then I think the other Bulbul won't even listen to Leila. She'll be like, "What are you? You're too young for me. Just leave."
But Avinash, what do you think that Leela and Bulbul, their conversation, and between Majnu and Satya, what would their conversation be?
I don't know what Bulbul and Satya would talk to them. Bulbul and Leela would say to each other, but I would say to them, if I had a chance to meet both of them, I would say, please don't let him go. Be it Kes or Satya. Yeah.
Please don't want to go to London in every film. Leela Majnu also, this one also. Daro my London, 4 saal, 5 saal.
So yeah, Majnu and Satya, I think Kes and Satya would probably be friends. They can, they would have become friends. Just that both of them have this kind of, Kes is obviously outwardly and has seen the world. It seems like he has a depth to it. Satya, to me, was very ignorant and naive. But they did have the good heart, which I think would connect for both of them, which is why they would be friends. That's how I look at it, yeah.
Tripti, coming to you, playing the titular Bulbul, which is like an innocent, naive girl. And suddenly you see her transformation because, as they say, a beautiful woman is dangerous. She can be dangerous if she's rubbed the wrong way. What was most challenging for you and your experience playing Bulbul when she came to you? Like, could you grasp it? Could you relate to her at any level?
I think the best part was that I had a lot of time to prep for it. Mera December mein shayad selection ho gaya tha and we started shooting in Feb. So I had good 2 months to understand this girl, to get into her headspace and understand her physicality. And me and Anvita, we spent a lot of time together in those 2 months. We tried to, understand this girl's journey and, understand how she talks or how she thinks or how she reacts to situations. And, we would sometimes try and draw similarities between me and Bulbul. And that's when we realized that I, as a person, am more close to the one that's innocent, that's a little confused all the time, and not to the one that's, not to the transformed Bulbul. So that is, we had to work really hard on the latter part. And we had our workshops with Atul Mungia. And I was given this very strange but very useful exercise to understand her physicality and her mental being, which was to just focus on my breath and just to, be more focused on myself and less focused on what's going, on the outside. So that's what we worked on. And it was challenging, but Anvita was always there to help me understand, and all these amazing co-actors that I have in the film, they were always there to help me understand things and they were always there to support me. So I think that just made my job a little easier there.
And then you have, playing Satya, a man who somewhere understands also, but also sometimes gets frustrated at his inability to solve it. What was Satya for you, Avinash?
Honestly, I'll tell you, when I read the script, I absolutely love the story and screenplay. But I was still not very sure about Satya in my head because, I found him to be too innocent and naive, and almost said this a few times. I almost thought he was dumb. He comes across as when you see him, he's the audience in a way, because he sees what the audience sees, or the audience sees what he sees. And in the run-through of the film, in that narrative, the audience happens to know, in fact, one part of the that film knows much more than Satya. The audience knows much more than Satya. So on paper, he seemed to be a guy who is dumb because, the world knows more than him. And then eventually, so I was not, I honestly would say that I was not very sure if I should do this until I came across that one line where Bulbul says, "Ab tum bhi unki tarah ho gaye ho." What's that line? Is that the line? That's the line,
right? Tum sab ek jaise ho.
And tum sab ek jaise ho. And to me, that really stood out for Satya. That's a conversation, considering the message of the film. I also wanted to see that, to me, Satya did everything right and still became a part of the patriarchs that we identified in the film. And that is what I related so much in our society, where a lot of people who don't have, they they have to be, but they're just product of that system that they become patriarchs without even realizing it and identifying it. So that became extremely interesting. Let's explore this. I really want to, and I'm still in a conversation with myself about it, of why tum bhi unke jaise ho gaye ho, is something that goes on in my head, and I hope if it can reach out to people and the audience can start talking about that, would be something very interesting.
I like something you really you said recently. I know there's this whole debate going, outsiders versus insiders, us and them. You said something very interesting that another young talent has said. It's at the end of the day, the audience that makes or breaks you.
Yeah.
And after that, it's your path to do. What, I mean, what's your take? Because someone new in the industry who's now beginning his own journey, what's your take?
Almost 17 years in this industry. It took 15 years for me to get my first opportunity as a lead film actor with Ella Mujhe. So yes, you go through a lot of struggles. You feel like, I wish there was a way out and I could get this opportunity, you know, in an easier way. That's a privilege that I don't have, and some might have. But eventually, yeah, when that film came out, where I got the opportunity and I was put it out, it was put out, it's the audience that did not come to see the film. So it eventually gets down the audience to come and watch the film. If they had watched the film, it would really hopefully have done well, and it would have become much more easier for an outsider to do job in this industry and become part of the so-called insider, which we all want to be. I don't know why, but because we've just put one center, and I'm glad I'm wearing this t-shirt today. Power, I believe. Yes. That you have one center of power somewhere, and that is all that we want to be and we desire of. So that is something I never associated with. So this insider-outsider conversation really does not make sense. I'm here to do my job. I'm getting an opportunity to do that. Yes, it is difficult if you're not privileged. So it is for anyone in any kind of industry, especially when it's driven consumers. And the consumers, if they accept and if they fall into place, the buck lies with the audience. Anyway, yeah, I want to add this, like I keep saying this, someone very wise told me once, you get the government you deserve, you get the cinema you deserve, and which is why it's most important as an audience that you choose, as a consumer, choose everything that we pay money for and make that choice sensibly.
So I agree with you. Tripti, do you want to add something?
I think I'll take it from personal experience. My film Leela Majnu was released in like 2018, and it was there in the theaters for I think 7 days. And I think I went for all the shows, and I think maximum 25 people dekhe honge maine shayad in the theaters. And that was, you know, and I still get messages. Even today, I get more than 20 messages every day, you know, where people talk about Leela Majnu and how great it was. And, you know, they keep saying that, "Arey, hum kyun nahi gaye theater mein dekhne?" But that's what I think. Today we have a Kartik Aaryan who's from outside the industry, and people have loved his work, and which is why today he's a star. So I think the power lies in the audience's hands. Like, if you want, we'll be stars. If you don't want to see us, then nobody would want to invest money in us. Like, nobody would. If sure. Agar main mithai wala hu, and if nobody is buying my besan ka laddu, then why would I make besan laddus? I won't, right? So this is as simple as that.
And lastly, last question. They say on a set, kuch paranormal activity hoti hai. Kuch hua tha aap logon ke saath when you were playing Bulbul? You were playing a spooky film.
Kuch hua nahi, but I think Anvita ne experience kiya tha. I think there was the scene in the forest. You must have seen the last forest sequence that we did. So there's this tree, jiske upar Anvita ko shayad kuch dikha tha. But I've just heard stories. I don't know if it was actually there.
Yeah,
or not.
I've also heard that story. I think the story was she had gone to do the recce of that
for the recce,
tree.
Yeah.
And there were villagers around who came to said that we do puja of this tree because there's someone in their description there's a mata that comes on that tree, and they were doing a puja of that tree. So it just kind of she got really spooked,
and
because she had chosen that as a main tree. The same
thing. awesome. But guys, fantastic job. All the very best. Keep the good work going. And I thoroughly enjoyed Bulbul. So, I mean, stunning, haunting, mesmerizing, all those, I mean, the good work, I mean, praise that's coming your way, you too. Thank you so much.
Thank you.
Pleasure. Thank you.
Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you.